In other news now, the South African and Mozambican governments plan to unveil a memorial to honor those who were murdered in Matola in Mozambique 28 years ago. 13 people were killed in attacks by the apartheid military. According to Foreign Affairs Minister at the time, Nkosazana Dlamini-Zuma, the monument will serve as a constant reminder of the bonds of friendship between the people of Mozambique and South Africa. Well, we're now joined from Pretoria by the Department of Military Veterans spokesperson Mbulelo Musi, who himself is a survivor of what is the Matola raid. Mbulelo, good morning, and thank you very much for talking to us this morning. The importance of launching or inaugurating this memorial in Matola for survivors like yourself, what is it?
Well, then, and all the listeners, and the viewers, good morning. Well, indeed, it's a significant event as a survivor, but also for government and the people of South Africa and Mozambique, in that for many a year since 1981, many families have been having this pain of saying, at what point are we going to ensure that there is closure to a very painful chapter? You would have known that, and the viewers would have known that 13 people died on that day, were South Africans, members of the ANC and Umkhonto weSizwe. We also had a Portuguese citizen or national who also was killed during the raid. That raid symbolized a very painful period and chapter in the history of struggle. Many people were affected, and families were affected in the sense that they lost their loved one. However, it also was a watershed insofar as ensuring that the people of South Africa finally get freedom. Southern Africa becomes free. There is a bit stability. There's relations of cooperation between Mozambique and South Africa. And to the extent that we are saying we dare not forget that freedom was not cheap. Freedom was not free. It came at a cost. It must stand as a constant reminder. So we're very grateful as a survivor, representing all those who survived, representing all those who died on the day we were attacked. We are saying we want to welcome the government initiative. The Department of Arts and Culture, working with the Department of Military Veterans, Department of International Relations and Cooperation, and the Presidency, together with the Mozambicans, are going to be opening the monument on the 11th. The presidents of the two countries on the 11th of September in Mozambique, where we are saying to South Africans, we dare not forget, where we say to the Mozambicans, thank you for the sacrifices they made so that we are able to be free today. We have 21 years of freedom because many countries contributed, including Mozambique, which lost many people for the sake of our freedom.
I understand that the names of those who will be honored will not just be the 13 South Africans who were killed on that day in January 1981, but will also include other South African anti-apartheid stalwarts, like the names of those like Ruth Fest.
Yes, indeed. We've been able to trace, I think, about 10 of the families. We are looking forward to and also, of course, we're in touch with the Ruth Fest family. We want to announce to the public of South Africa to assist us to also trace, make sure that all the people who are affected by the raid are also present to be with the president, to be able to honor and remember those who fell in the struggle for freedom. We have people, families like family Mduduzeli Sibanyoni, Nelson Ndunamvula, Daniel Molebatsi, as well as others, as we say, who died in Mozambique in different times, Augustino Masonto, Muishe family, Habedi family, Mtembu family, Matakala, and Rapidzi. All those families would like them to come forward. I'm going to be leaving the number now, 082-338-3890, to contact me so that you can be able to make arrangements. We want to make sure that all the families that ought to be honored on that day and be recognized are indeed given that space.
Do you mind repeating the number again, 082?
082-338-3890.
390. And then those who know about those families can be in touch on that number, 082-338-3890. Now, very, very briefly, you said the presidents of the two countries, that's President Jacob Zuma and President Philip Nyusi of Mozambique, will be there, plus the families of those that you have managed to track down for the ceremony. What kind of program, very briefly, are you expecting to take place on the 11th of September in Matola?
Well, basically, the program will start at, maybe let me start this way. Families are expected to gather on the 8th. at the Southern Sun in the OR Tambo International. On the 9th, they travel to Mozambique. And then secondly, on the 11th, in the morning, there will be a wreath-laying ceremony. Ministers will be involved of both Mozambique and South Africa with their families. And then we proceed towards the monument and the interpretative center, where from 9 o'clock up to 1700 hours, the program will actually unfold. We are hoping that there's going to be plus minus 1,500 people attending, including their families. We want to say to the government of South Africa, we want to say to the people of Mozambique and the government of Mozambique, we are highly appreciative of this opportunity. It's long overdue, and indeed we must make sure that we continue to honor and in fact respect those made huge sacrifices so that we are free today.
Thank you very much. That's the Department of Military Veterans spokesperson Mbulelo Musi.